Hey everyone, my name is Stephanie, and this is What's New to the Edge Developer Tools in version 97. In version 97, the Detached Elements tool is now available by default. The 3D View tool supports changing color themes. There are improvements and bug fixes for the Focus Mode UI experiment. The Microsoft Edge DevTools extension for Visual Studio Code has been updated with screencast enhancements, deprecation warnings, and new launch options for Microsoft Edge. And version 97 also includes a few updates from the Chromium project. First up, the Detached Elements tool is now available by default in the DevTools. You can find it and add it to your toolbar under the More Tools button. The new Detached Elements tool finds all the detached elements on your page and displays them. You're able to expand and collapse a detached element to see the parent and child nodes that are being retained by the browser. You can trigger the browser's garbage collection by clicking the Collect Garbage icon, which will then confirm a memory leak when a detached element cannot be garbage collected. Clicking the Analyze button will take a heap snapshot and allow you to jump into the JavaScript code that's referencing the detached element. You can read more about detached DOM nodes in the What's New documentation at the link in the video description. The 3D View tool now supports changing color themes in DevTools. Since version 93, you've been able to apply various color themes from Visual Studio Code to the DevTools, in addition to the default light and dark themes provided by the DevTools. Previously, changing the theme color in DevTools and then opening the 3D View tool resulted in a blank panel. This issue has been fixed in Microsoft Edge 97, and you can use your 3D View tool uninterrupted with an applied color theme. In version 96, we introduced a new Developer Tools UI experiment called Focus Mode. Thank you to everyone who has tried out this new user interface and who has been providing feedback on this experiment. We're making improvements and bug fixes based on this feedback, and some of these things have landed in version 97. Focus Mode is still an experiment, and we're still eager to hear your feedback. All the same tools and custom themes that are currently available in the Developer Tools are available in Focus Mode. You can enable this experiment in the DevTools by going to the DevTools settings and then Experiments to turn it on. Next, the Microsoft Edge DevTools extension for Visual Studio Code has new screencast enhancements, deprecation warnings, and new launch options for Microsoft Edge. We fixed a number of issues in the extension that were reported by the community. These include the list of emulated devices in the screencast is now the same as the list of emulated devices in the browser. Device emulation now adds the correct user agent string to trigger the correct display. You now get a warning when you use a deprecated launch version of Microsoft Edge, indicating that you'd miss out on features. And you can now provide arguments for the launched browser instance in case you need to have a special setup. And finally, Microsoft Edge version 97 also includes the following updates from the Chromium project. You can refresh the device list in device mode. Autocomplete with edit as HTML is now available. And there's an improved code debugging experience. Be sure to check out the links in the video description for more information on these features from the Chromium project. And that's it for what's new in version 97 of the Microsoft Edge Developer Tools. Be sure to follow us on Twitter at MSEdgeDev and like and subscribe to stay tuned for what's coming next in version 98.